Our next speaker is Dr. Claudia Hernandez, who is Assistant Professor of Dermatology in the UIC College of Medicine and directs dermatological and clinical studies in the UIC residency program. She graduated from Northwestern University Medical School, completed her internship at the University of Chicago, and completed her residency in dermatology at Northwestern's Medical Center. She received the 2009 Women's Health Career Development Award from the Dermatology Foundation, which provided funding for her research on designing public health strategies to reduce skin cancer disparities. Please welcome Dr. Claudia Hernandez.
Dermatology has been an important presence here at UIC. We have provided care for those affected with skin diseases for over 110 years, making us one of the oldest dermatology departments in the country. I joined the department back in 2005. One of the things that attracted me to UIC was that it had much more diverse patient population than where I did my residency. This meant that I started to see diseases that were more common among individuals of color. One example is called vitiligo. It produces milky white patches on the skin. It is also known as Michael Jackson's disease for its most famous patient. Because of the sharp contrast between the white patches and an individual's normal skin, it is psychologically devastating. I wrote an essay about how unfair it was to deny individuals of color treatment for vitiligo because insurance companies considered the disease cosmetic. My essay about the overlooked personal impact of vitiligo in skin of color patients earned me a national fellowship. I received training on health policy issues and learned how to advocate for my patients. I even got to travel and practice my skills on Capitol Hill. I decided to make healthcare inequalities or healthcare disparities the focus of my research. Now, in 2007, researchers made a surprising find about skin cancer. If you were Black or Hispanic and were diagnosed with a skin cancer, you were much more likely to die from it than if you were white. I was finishing my health policy fellowship around this time and realized a new healthcare disparity had been described in my own field. Skin cancer affects everyone, no matter what skin color, but most public education programs gave the impression that only whites got skin cancer, and individuals of color may have believed they were not at risk and ignored the message. I decided to develop a program to disseminate skincare education to Spanish-speaking communities using lay health workers. Now, lay health workers are motivated community volunteers. They are natural leaders and are often the people that community members turn to if they need advice. Lay workers can be trained on healthcare issues so they can share their knowledge. They are also less likely to encounter mistrust and language barriers since they work in their own community. We focused on Spanish speakers with limited English language skills on the south and west sides of Chicago and began by conducting community surveys. We found that most did not believe they were at risk for skin cancer, they did not get regular skin checks from a doctor, and they did not know how to check their skin for warning signs of skin cancer. We developed a skin cancer education program and trained lay workers to spread the word. We got people to check their skin and attend skin cancer screenings. Because our program motivated change in health behaviors, I received the International Award for Social Responsibility in Dermatology in 2011. Next, I decided to develop Spanish language educational videos about sun protection, since most U.S. Hispanics do not use sunscreen. Two UIC medical students spent their summer in Pilsen showing the video in area businesses such as beauty salons. Their efforts to motivate healthy behaviors helped the students win the UIC Gold Humanism Award for their work. Although I was able to educate, I wanted to find a way to deliver care and reduce delays for those living in underserved areas, where many face months of delays to get access to a doctor. I am working on a telemedicine project that uses a portable device that sends high-resolution photographs of skin lesions to doctors using a data link. The device is small and can be carried by a lay health worker or nurse practitioner and then send the photograph to a doctor for an opinion about the potential risk. Those living in underserved areas could be more effectively triaged and sent to specialty care. This could potentially reduce wait times among the poor. The last project I want to tell you about is my work on medical simulation. I first learned its potential applications as part of a UIC program called Scholars for Teaching Excellence. Simulation allows medical students to practice and perfect their clinical skills in a safe environment. They can repeatedly practice a skill and master it before they see a patient. Now, medical students and residents may rarely get a chance to encounter skin cancer in an individual of color. My idea was to develop a medical simulation that would allow students to practice skin cancer detection and develop confidence on examining patients. I partnered with UIC's Dr. Allen and Mary L. Graham Clinical Performance Center. I was quite lucky because the Performance Center had over a decade of experience using simulated patients. They also use only professional actors that you might see if you were to go see a professional theater production, allowing us to do realistic simulations. By combining these trained actors with what we call a moulage, or temporary skin tattoo, we were able to create simulated scenarios that allowed students to practice examining a patient with skin cancer. We've been able to allow hundreds of students to practice, and this technique has become a valuable learning tool. We have developed scenarios that can assess a medical student's ability using patients of different ethnicities. We've also figured out that students needed more training on how to correctly ask about skin cancer risk factors. Simulation has allowed us to figure out ways to help patients. Residents are not immune to the uses of simulation. We have developed communication and interpersonal skill exercises for dermatology residents. This allows us to assess how residents handle difficult patient encounters, such as patients who refuse a biopsy of an obvious skin cancer, and if they know how to effectively use a medical interpreter. We have even developed scenarios and trained actors to become secret shoppers. These actors are trained to an extremely high level to escape detection by a doctor in their own private office. This allows us to see what happens behind closed doors and if doctors are following recommended guidelines. Our skin cancer education program using actors was recently funded by the National Institutes of Health. The emphasis on education is essential because treatments for advanced skin cancer, such as melanoma, remain limited, making early detection key to survival. So I encourage you to wear sunscreen and not to be afraid to ask your doctor for a skin check. It will have a transformative impact on your well-being.